Hey guys, what is up? It's me, Amelia. Welcome back to my channel. So today I don't really know what I'm gonna title this video, but basically, like, for each Billie Eilish song, I'm gonna be like matching it with a young adult book. So I guess it could be in like a recommendations format. Like, if you like this Billie Eilish song, you might like this book, or just like matching them in general. I made one for Lorde, so if you love Lorde's music, I'll link that video down below. It's one of my favorite videos and it did not get enough love. Sorry if I'm a little bit quiet, like I don't want my family to hear me filming. So yeah, today I'm also wearing green because it's Billie Eilish's signature color, sort of. Like, her website is green, her merch is green, she wears green. Okay, so let's just start with the first song, Bury a Friend. It's like pretty popular. I feel like people know it if you know Billie Eilish's music. The book that I chose for Bury a Friend is Six of Crows or Crooked Kingdom. I just feel like, you know that quote in the series, like, no mourners, no funerals? Like, you don't wanna bury your friend. You don't wanna mourn them. You don't wanna have funerals for them. But then it's like, Bury a Friend by Billie Eilish. The tone or the mood of the music, I feel like it's very Six of Crows, if you know what I mean. So I just played, like, a part of the song and chose some Six of Crows stuff so that you can, like, get a feel for it. Satisfactory. Today I'm thinking about the things that are deadly. The way I'm drinking you down, like I wanna drown, like I wanna end me. Step on the glass, staple your tongue, bury a friend. Okay, next up is You Should See Me in a Crown. For this, I chose the Throne of Glass series by Sarah J. Maas. I mean, like, no spoilers or anything, but you know how the lyrics are like, if you think I'm pretty, you should see me in a crown? That's pretty much Aelin. I don't think she wears a crown all the time, but it's definitely something she would say, like, if you think I'm pretty, you should see me in a crown, dude. The other lyrics as well, like, we're gonna run this nothing town, watch me make them bow one by one, and their silence is my favorite sound, like, she'll kill them. Blood on a marble wall, it's very like blood in a palace, which there's pretty much war happening in a palace. So I feel like You Should See Me in a Crown is like really Throne of Glass. It's the most Throne of Glass Billie Eilish song ever. And also has like a very royals vibe, like a crown and, like, you know, royals in the series. You should see me in a crown. I'm gonna win this nothing town. Watch me make them bow one by one by one. Okay, so next up is Watch by Billie Eilish. And for Watch, the series that I chose is, I can't find it. Here. It's The Crow Prince by Holly Black. For The Crow Prince, I literally had three songs. I ended up choosing Watch. Okay. Lips meet teeth and tongue, my heart skips 8 beats at once. If we were meant to be, we would have been by now. See what you want to see, but all I see is him right now. Go ahead and watch my heart burn with the fire that you started in me, but I'll never let you back to put it out. Your love feels so fake. Because basically, well, I don't want to spoil the series, but if you got to the end of The Wicked King, then you know what I'm talking about. And then especially this. When you call my name, do you think I'll come running? You never did the same, so good at giving me nothing. And then especially this part. When you close your eyes, do you picture me? When you fantasize, am I your fantasy? Now you know, now I'm free. And it's just like, never gonna let you back. So I'll play a little, like, song with Crow Prince visuals here. Lips me. Teeth and tongue, my heart skips 8 beats at once. If we were meant to be, we would have been by now. I guess it has to do the most with, like, when you fantasize about your fantasy, like, because Cardian freaking loves Jude loves Cardian, but they just don't admit it. And it's like, with the fire that you started in me, because, like, they started a fire in each other. Next is Hostage by Billie Eilish, duh. Hostage is basically about a girl who wants a guy to, like, keep liking her, etc., but she doesn't want to, like, admit her feelings. And for that, I chose the Shatter Me series, especially the second half of Unravel Me and Ignite Me. Juliet, Warner loves her, and she kind of knows it. And she wants Warner to love her, okay? but she just doesn't admit her feelings when he's like, do you love me? And she's like, I don't know how I feel. It's like she's holding him hostage, like figuratively. She's holding his love hostage because she's not responding back to it, but she wants him to like keep loving her, you know? So it's very hostage. And some of the lyrics are, I don't know what to do with your kiss on my neck. Or, I don't know what feels true, but this feels right, so stay a sec. Yeah, you feel right, so stay a sec. And let me crawl inside your veins. It's not like me to be so mean. Oh my god, literally. Like when she shoots him or when she says Adam, when he's like, call me Warner, and she's like, Adam. So it's like, it's not like me to be so mean. You're all I wanted. Just let me hold you like a hostage. And it's like, kiss me until I can't speak. And the shirt that you let me wear home. I'm pretty sure Juliet wore Warner's shirt, like, at least once. And nothing hurts when I'm alone, when you're with me and we're alone. This is, like, perfect. Hostage is 100% shatter me. Or, like, unravel me and ignite me. But if you're, like, into, like, a girl holding a guy hostage, like, figuratively, then you'll probably really like the Shatter Me series. Okay, next up. It's for you devouring gray lovers. Oh wait, am I supposed to say the song first? Anyways, it's for you devouring gray lovers. I recently read that book a few days ago. I really liked it. 4.5 stars. And for the devouring gray, I chose Lovely by Billie Eilish. Especially the music video. The music video is 100% the devouring gray. Okay, some lyrics that I think work for the devouring gray is, oh, I hope someday I'll make it out of here. If you read the book, you know what I mean. And even if it takes all night or 100 years, need a place to hide, but I can't find one near. Wanna feel alive outside, I can fight my fear. Also, tear me to pieces, skin and bone. Skin and bone is very devouring gray, if you know what I mean. Like, the corpses and walking out of town. You know, it's a very, like, town. The devouring gray is like a town looking for a better place. End of the song, which is like, hello, welcome home. She's like pretty much like home. It's like her mom's hometown. I'll play some parts of the music video that is very the devouring gray. Like, it's very blue, sad, somber. It's just perfect. Wanna feel alive outside, I can't find my fear. Isn't it lovely, all alone? Heart made of glass, my mind of stone. Tear me to pieces, skin and bone. So if you really love the song Lovely, you'll definitely love the devouring gray. Like, I really think you will. Okay, next up is Bitches Broken Hearts by Billie Eilish. That song is one of my favorite Billie Eilish songs. I have, I think, two favorites. It's that one and 6 Feet Under, but I also love, like, the rest. For this song, I chose the Red Queen series, but not Red Queen. I'd say it's the second book and the fourth book, even though I never finished the fourth book. But if you're a Mare and Maven shipper, then this is your song. So the lyrics go, you can pretend you don't miss me, you can pretend you don't care, all you wanna do is kiss me, oh what a shame I'm not there. That's so sad, like when Mare and Maven are apart, I am a Mare and Maven shipper, but then Victoria Aveyard had to take my body, chop it up in pieces, and feed it to the pigs. What is it you want? You can lie, but I know that you're not fine. Every time you talk about me, but you swear I'm not on your mind. Okay, this part. Every now and then it hits me that I'm the one that got away. She literally, like, got away. And then this part is in Maven's point of view, but I guess being lonely fits me, and you were made for begging, stay. Oh my god. I'm, like, really sad right now. I'm sorry. I never even finished the last book yet, but that's just so them. Like, Mare pretty much got away, and then Maven's like, I'm lonely, but I guess it fits me, because you were made for begging stay, but like, you didn't stay. Yeah, I'm like in my feels. Okay, next up is When I Was Older, which is a soundtrack that she like, that was inspired by the movie Roma.
Hi guys! My name is Angie. Go follow my Instagram.
She's actually a monster. Okay, for When I Was Older, I really love this song. It's one of my favorites. And basically the vibe of the song that Billie was trying to make was like singing from underwater. If you listen to the song, it's literally like, it's like she's singing underwater. So for this, I chose To Kill a Kingdom by... I actually have all the books I talk about. I should have just shown them. But it's To Kill a Kingdom by Alexandra Christo or Christo. It's very To Kill a Kingdom. To Kill a Kingdom is basically in the perspective of like these sirens or like mermaids underwater. And there's some like stuff going on. But I think the lyrics that work is like, when I was older, I was a sailor on an open sea. So the lyrics are very like the sea, and it's like, but now I'm underwater and my skin is paler than it could ever be. So I feel like it's very siren or like mermaid-y. I'll insert like the song with some visuals of this book so you can see what I'm talking about.
When I was older, I was a
is my favorite Billie Eilish song right now. This is my go-to song right now. My favorite song of hers is always changing, but like for like this like week, it's My Strange Addiction. I love it. It's so good. You guys have probably been waiting for A Court of Thorns and Roses to come because it's my favorite series, and for My Strange Addiction, it is A Court of Thorns and Roses. Actually, right here, you can't see it, but it's A Court of Frost and Starlight. Well, A Court of Winds and Ruin too, I guess. It's for Cassian and Nesta, my OTP, even though their book didn't even come out yet. But basically, My Strange Addiction, Cassian is so addicted to Nesta, like... So some lyrics that is very Cassian and Nesta is, don't ask questions you don't want to know, learned my lesson way too long ago. I guess that's in Cassian's perspective, like, don't talk to Nesta because she doesn't want to talk to you. Take what I want when I wanna and I want ya, like in Echo Fest when he leaves Feyre's house to go to Nesta, it's like, I'll take what I want when I want to and I want you, and then he like follows her home. And then it just repeats like, you are my strange addiction. And also, put your lips on my skin and you might ignite it, hurts but I know how to hide it, kinda like it. I don't know, I feel like it just works. Hurts but I know how to hide it. Cassian is so hurt by Nesta, but he knows how to hide it.
And it burns like a chin and I like it. Put your lips on my skin and you might ignite it. Hurts but I know how to hide it. Kinda like it.
Okay, this one. Okay, the song is Bad Guys or Bad Guy. I couldn't really find a song for Bad Guy. Like, nothing worked. So I just, like, found a random one. Okay, Bad Guy is pretty much, like, the lyrics are just, like, I'm a bad guy. I'm a bad guy, I'm a bad guy. I actually really like this song. Fun fact, Billie Eilish edited the music video by herself on her mom's laptop in the iMovie app. Like, skills. Bad guy lyrics. I actually know the lyrics, I swear, but like, I just cannot remember them right now. She just keeps saying like, I'm that bad type, I'm the bad guy, I'm the bad guy, only good at being bad, I'm a bad guy. Okay, it's The Young Elise by Marie Lu, and that's the only book I know where the protagonist is like a villain, so I just feel like I'm a bad guy with her because she's like pretty bad. Like, she kills people, like, I don't know. Just skip this one, please. Okay, next up is Ocean Eyes, which is pretty much like her first song. So for Ocean Eyes, I chose The Inferno Devices. I never finished this series, but... what can you do? For this, I chose it because of Will Herondale's eyes, because they're really blue, and like, that just keeps getting mentioned. So I'm like, for Ocean Eyes, I just had to find someone with blue eyes, and that was Will. Next up is All the Good Girls Go to Hell, which is one of my favorites as well. For this, I chose Sweet Evil, not because of like the lyrics or, well, not because of any... My sister is singing a Billie Eilish song right now. I'm trying to think like what song that is. Oh, when the party's over. Oh, I don't have When the Party's Over. I couldn't find a book for that. Okay, so for Sweet Evil, All the Good Girls Go to Hell. Because I feel like Sweet Evil, it's very like God, demon, devil, angel book. And I feel like All the Good Girls Go to Hell, the song, it's also very like hell, heaven, devil, God. The song is actually, I think it's about like global warming and the world ending. The lyrics are like, okay, the first sentence is my Lucifer is lonely. And then there's also like even God herself. So it's like Lucifer, God, Peter, which is I think like a Bible reference or something. My God is gonna own me. There's nothing left to save now. I guess it's just like the God and like the Lucifer devilish references, which kind of match with this because there's like fallen angels. And each person is like, I haven't read this in a while, but I feel like they are the children of like some angels or something. Like angel of lust angel of drugs. I don't know. But I couldn't really find another book with like God and Lucifer. I didn't want to do Fallen Angels, the book. The vibe just wasn't it. Okay, next up is 6 Feet Under, one of my favorites. And for 6 Feet Under, I chose Legend by Marie Lu, but more specifically the last book. She's coming out with a new book. The third book, called Champion. If you've read the series, you know what I'm talking about. 6 Feet Under is basically like, help, I lost myself again, but I remember you. And it's also like, our love is 6 feet under. I can't help but wonder if our grave was watered by the rain, would roses bloom? I don't want to spoil, but the two love interests, their love is kind of 6 feet under. Their love is like dead. And then it's like, but if our grave was watered, would roses bloom? So like, could our love come back? Help, I lost myself again, but I remember you. If you've read the series, you know what I mean. Like, there's a lot of remembering someone and forgetting someone, and there's a lot of like, can we bring our love back to life? So I just feel like 6 Feet Under really works for Champion. Okay, next up, the song is Copycat, and I wrote Shadow and Bone, but right now I don't remember why I wrote Shadow and Bone. I have no idea why I chose Shadow and Bone. I don't think it's because of the lyrics, because I didn't find any lyrics that match. I feel like it's more of the tone or the mood that you get from the song. So I'll play like a part of the song with like some Shadow and Bone visuals so that you can like imagine the vibe.
Don't be cautious, don't be kind. You committed, I'm your crime. Push my button anytime. You got your finger on the trigger, but your trigger finger's mine.
Okay, next up is Listen Before I Go. And this is not the lyrics or anything, it's literally just the vibe or tone of the song. I actually made a video where I defaced Winter Song, so I made this. It's just like roses. And yeah, Winter Song. This is the original cover. Just Listen Before I Go. The tone or the mood of the song is just very the mood of Winter Song. So I'll just play like a part of the song. If you've read the book, then you know what I mean.
Take me to the rooftop. I wanna see the world when I stop breathing.
And then the last one that I have is Zanny by Billie Eilish. Zanny is about a girl who doesn't understand why like people who like take drugs, smoke, like those kids are popular, and she's just like not one of them. The lyrics are like, I'm in their secondhand smoke, still just drinking canned coke. I don't need a Zanny or Xanax to feel better. I'm like the designated drive home, only one who's not stoned. I don't need a Zanny to feel better. Okay, I couldn't really find a book where the main character like doesn't like the popular kids that like take drugs. I feel like a lot of books have that, but I just couldn't find it. So I just went with Two Other Boys I've Loved Before. You know, like the ski trip. It's not really her crowd. She didn't want to go to the party that Peter wanted to take her to, you know, so I feel like that kind of works. But yeah, that's pretty much me like matching Billie Eilish songs to young adult books, or just like recommending the book if you like the song. I hope you enjoyed. I think I'm gonna make this like a series. Like whenever I'm really obsessed with an artist, I'll just do this for them, like I did for Lord Billie. Let me know if you agree with any of the things I chose, or if you have a better match. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.
And it burns like a chin, and I like it. Put your lips on my skin and you might ignite it. Hurts, but I know how to hide it. Kinda like it.